least now we know about this place. But yeah, looking forward to doing some observation from the beach for you guys. So hopefully the sun's going to come up somewhere.
This was Flatzoid on a summer holidays in Margate, South Africa during the 2023 December solstice, which sees the sunrise over the Tropic of Capricorn. Now Flatz was in the best position possible to once and for all stick it to the globers by showing the direction of sunrise, which on a flat earth would occur somewhat north of east. But, for some reason unknown to the world of science, Flatz decided a Nobel Prize wasn't for him and elected not to show the exact moment of his sunrise, which, according to SunCalc, occurred at some time around 4:52 a.m. with an azimuth of about 118 degrees. And that's in this direction from his balcony. Notice how the arrow goes through this little outbuilding here. That's this one. So that puts sunrise about here, which is about 28 degrees south of east. There have been some great videos about this already by WheresWally and Flat Earth Math, and I'll of course link those in the description below. But what I'd like to do in this video is to check SunCalc, grab the geographical positions of where the sun was directly overhead at 2 a.m. and 8 p.m. on the day of the solstice, and then construct my own geometry showing the azimuth values for every minute in between those times. So we'll start off with a slider for the 18 hours we're to look at in minutes. This is our sphere, the North Pole, the South Pole, the equator, the Greenwich Meridian, the Tropic of Cancer, Capricorn, and the map. This text serves as a preset for the next 10 variables. Here we can define the observer's location, the sun's starting and ending positions, and the delta position change for each minute elapsed. Point A here in white is our observer, and that is controlled by these lat and long variables. This path sequence will allow us to position this point for the sun, for any time over the 18-hour span. These will draw parts of great circles originating from the observer, with one going to the North Pole and the other going to the GP of the sun. This handy vector helps us with direction, while these vectors will help us measure the azimuth angle and also show the direction of where the sun is out in space. Angle theta is our measured azimuth angle, while lambda is the longitude of the sun's GP. The rest is all to do with on-screen text. One problem I have with SunCalc is that I can't intuitively picture where it is the sun is directly overhead for any time stated. It does tell you down here with the GHA and declination, but you do have to convert that yourself to latitude and longitude if you really wanted to know. The sun's GP for the time of 4:52 a.m. is a tad east of Alice Springs in Australia's Northern Territory, which is about here. So the main reason why I made this was really to help me visualise the data and give me a better understanding as to what is actually going on. Let's take a look at the information currently displayed on screen. We have Flatz down here at the seaside, and these are his coordinates. The GP of the sun is currently somewhere around the curve, somewhere near Fiji, and its location information is here. And here we have the observer's true altitude and azimuth angles to the sun. While these numbers will closely match those of SunCalc, my altitude angle doesn't include refraction, so it might be a little off when the sun is low in the sky. If we add in some arcs of great circles, we get two direction lines from which we can measure the azimuth angle. It doesn't really make much sense until we center on the observer. So in response to WheresWally, Flatzoid gave us these shots where he shows the sun's position 1 hour after sunrise at 5:46 a.m. And we can see that SunCalc gives us an azimuth of 111 degrees for this time. Once again, we can check the line from his balcony, and it still ticks us over that outbuilding, but more to the left of it this time. And we can also use this to help us visualise where the sun is out in space. This is where the sun is overhead. Both vectors point towards us. This is the observer's altitude angle to the sun. And this will be the highest in the sky that it gets. So I guess Flatzoid still hasn't explained this one yet. I guess he never will. And that will keep his followers happy because they don't really want explanations, do they? The globe model, on the other hand, explains everything we see. Simply, simultaneously, and without any conflict.